up here at Agave Hill on a Saturday afternoon. It's about 3:30. And it's a bit thermic still, and there's a system that's approaching. Up here with my buddy Dave from Alaska. He's sitting over there. Usually 80% of my flights are solo.
No one even around?
Got a whole city of 500,000 people down there. One of the reasons I fly with this Garmin inReach. This is a satellite tracking messenger system. I subscribe to the Geos Extreme Rescue Plan.
Yeah, I have an inReach in my backpack.
They're nice.
Yeah, but I only have it in case I need to, in case I'm seriously injured or something out in the middle of nowhere.
Well, that's one of the main reasons I have it, but it's also very useful for just letting people know, like I already sent my I'm getting ready to launch ping to my group, and when I land okay, I'll send them my landed okay ping.
You know, these grasshoppers are putting your flying skills to shame. They don't care if it's windy, they just launch and they go where they want.
They also are staying really close to the ground where the wind gradient is, the wind's weaker.
Memories of New Mexico is the sharp line of the land against the sky when I'm looking up the mountain, how sharp it is, because the air is so low humidity and clear.
Today it's a little polluted.
Well, out in the distance, but I'm talking about right here.
Oh yeah.
Like classic New Mexico.
Yeah, really nice blue.
Well, that wind has gotten pretty gentle and steady.
You take advantage of that to build a wall. You might want to stand clear a little. It's going to go right where you're standing. Thank you. I was very happy with that flight. An excellent landing and a decent launch. It was quite interesting in the air.